welcome to the Chakra Roof Meditation. We're trying to figure out how to set up a second camera here, so bear with me for a minute. You see it?
It's, oh, playing now.
It should show up in your live.
Okay, live.
So now you're on there, and then you're signing on.
See on the app. It says live.
Oh, you have to install the app then. Oh, that's okay if you don't want to do that.
Sorry, I need to do all that. I'm just not.
No, don't worry about it. That was just an idea of like getting more fancy and our technical.
I don't have Facebook on my phone.
Facebook. It's just the tool.
You look great, actually.
Well, as we're getting started and I see nobody's on yet, I'll set up my other stuff. And then I'll start talking a little bit about how... So at some point I wanted to figure out how to meditate because I was going through some personal stuff, and it was a pretty dark time, and I tried meditating many times before but hadn't really gotten through to it. And then I gave it another try, and then at some point I sat there and I was like, oh, the main thing about meditating is the breathing, because when you focus on your breathing, that's when you actually stop like running in your thoughts and things like that. And then I came to think of, yeah, okay, great, you're a horn player and breathing is kind of like your gig anyway, so duh, why didn't you figure this out before? And that brought me to play the shakuhachi, which is basically really hard to play if you're trying to do anything fancy in thrills or stuff like that. So the mind state to play it has to be really calm, and for the first 2 years or so, maybe half the time I was sitting there and just blowing air and just going like, no, something's gonna come out, but just keep going. And then every once in a while you get this really big note and it's like, ah, nice, you know. But there would be days where I'm like sitting there and it's basically just a stick of wood in my hands and I'm feeling really frustrated. So that was like the beginning of me actually sitting and just breathing. So I kind of used the flute to trick myself into sitting down and learning to sit. And then at some point I learned to sit without the flute. Yeah, like that. So you guys know me that much. And then at some point I was like at the Russian-Turkish baths, and there was like a discussion about what meditating really is. And one of the older guys that's like, you know, the kind of guy that always sits there in the corner quietly and kind of lean and like, he suddenly said, he's like, oh, if you're able to sit for like 50 minutes or an hour, that's a Zen meditation right there. Everything else that's going on in your head doesn't matter. It's the fact that you're sitting down and giving yourself the time, and then there's no doing it right or doing it wrong. It's like the minute where you sit, you are meditating. So I thought it was an interesting aspect where, like, if you want to free it of all kind of like spiritual or religious ends, just sitting down is a practical thing to do to like come to yourself. Okay, long story short, before I went on my recent trip to Colombia, my friend Clark Gayton, who is an amazing trombone player, came up to me and was like, oh, I was introduced to these websites that talk about frequencies that influence the chakra centers, the chakra wheels in the body, and I want to put together like a band with like gongs and things like that, and you're playing those flutes, so I thought maybe we can do something together. And so I had that in the back of my mind before I went on my trip to Colombia, and I met these great medicine musicians down there, and they hooked me up with like two more flutes. And as I came back, I figured out that those two flutes are actually in exactly in the sacral chakra, sitting right in the center of where your inhibition sits and the center of your joy, and basically the ability to speak freely and be yourself, basically. So I feel like they gifted me this thing, and on top of it, like one of the flutes has like an orange band around it, which is the color of the sacral chakra. So these guys know something about their stuff over there in Colombia, yeah. So let me move on. What else did I want to? Oh yeah, so that brings me to the colors and the frequencies. So there is a few websites out there, and I haven't really taken the time to dig through all of them, but I came across one that has the color spectrum going from orange, red, yellow, green, bluish, turquoise into violet, and then the frequency spectrum, and that I can't remember the numbers right now, but it basically starts from like the lower hundreds frequencies and then moves up. And one of these websites basically proclaims that they are the only ones who have perfectly matched the frequencies of the colors and the sounds. I think there's some kind of traditional thing to it that just speaks for the fact that those things work. I don't know if you have to exactly sit down and like put a meter to it and be like, oh, it's here, no, it's there, or something like that, you know. I feel like if this flute is at 432 hertz instead of 440 hertz, and that's the sacral frequency, then I'm just gonna run with that. And if I by accident find that this website tells me that, yeah, the sacral frequency is actually the one that's about a few hertz off from a Western tuning, then that kind of confirms the theory. But in the end, it's a little bit like astrology, where you're like, okay, I mean, you know, the moon goes around and then the sun, and then somebody comes out and they're like, oh no, I can prove that that's wrong. You know, what are you gonna do? But in the end, that's why I'm here today with you guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. And we are keeping the social distancing, that's at least 10 feet. And so what I'm interested in is, as I'm moving through the frequencies, I'm gonna give you guys a little, like a cheat sheet, so to say, before each frequency. And I'm actually cheating myself. I'm gonna read this off of one of those websites, just about what these chakras are said to encompass in the body, and then also what emotionally might be attached to that, etc. So that I think might be an interesting thing to meditate on, but then at the same time, that's just an idea. You guys might as well just shut it off and just stay in your meditation. If your meditation is that strong, I want to hear about it after, and I'd be very happy about that too, if you can just shut out my talking in between. How are we doing time wise? I'm like, I feel like I talked for half an hour, but it's probably
7, 5,
just been
1.
Okay, so I like officially I was gonna talk for like another 10 minutes now. I think that's a little much, but I think I have some more notes here. Let me see. The colors. Oh yeah, so in that one website that I'm gonna quote out of, they actually have some yoga poses going along with each chakra. So if anybody wants to try that while we're here, or anybody wants to try it at home, if anybody's trying it at home, it would be great to take a picture and post it. And yeah, I'd like to also know if you're practicing meditation on a regular basis, or you have a hobby or a pastime that gets you to a meditative state. I'd like to hear about it as well in the comments, in terms of Corona and the lockdown and how that's affected your practice, and if you've maybe found some a deeper connection to the things that actually ground you and help you connect with the surroundings that you're unable to connect with right now. So I found this practice to help me a lot, and that's basically what I'm trying to share here, is how to find things that help you disconnect from the problems and connect with the things that, that sustain you and nourish you. I think that's it for the notes. So maybe we should just start with like a 5-minute meditation, and then I start playing, huh? How about that? Yeah. What do you guys feel about that? Somebody give me a
time?
Oh no, I have it right here. So that was the root chakra. If you're able to feel it, it'll be right behind your pelvis. In the key of A, and this is a bansuri from India. And now moving up to the sacral chakra. Right around the area behind your navel. They say it's where your joy and your connectedness are at play. When you hold on to feelings or you don't speak your mind on the regular, you might find that you're knotted down in this area. But if it's free, then you have a joyful flow of energies and probably also, hopefully, good digestion. So may this hiperidu help us open that joyful space that I don't really give a damn spot. So for the sacral, because it's so much fun, I usually like to do two. Also because I have two. And because they're both from Colombia and I love Colombia. So this is a couple of hertz higher than this one. I don't know if you'll be able to tell the difference. But same chakra, so I'm gonna shut up and play.
Thank you.
solar plexus to the lower heart chakra. Coming from the color yellow, slowly going into a bright green. Opening the heart. Heart chakra. I guess chakras, it's lower heart chakra, the fire trucks wanted to add their two cents in, and the birds. The birds always show up when the heart is concerned. We're staying in the heart chakra, moving up to the root B. And I'll leave it with that. If you're focusing on colors, you want to think of a deeper green now. Like it's solid. Tasty deep green. Not quite dark. last of the heart chakra frequencies, the upper heart chakra. I'm gonna go back to Bansuri from India. We're now meditating on matters of the heart, so if there's things that hold you back, that's a good place to focus on. As we're moving up in the chakras and crossing the heart meridian, I'm gonna infuse my playing with a little more lively note as we're now opening up the upper chakras. Okay. Enough words. Thank you for bearing with me. Thank you. guys are great meditators. We made it like 2/3 of the way. Namaste. Moving to the throat chakra, and I'm staying with the feelings. That's what I remember right now. So what I remember about the throat chakra is everything around your neck area and your throat has to be loose for your energies to travel from your mind to your body, so your mind and body can connect and be in one place. So when we're struggling, we tense up, and this is basically the conduit that tightens everything up. So I often feel pain right here behind my ears, and that's something that's concerned with holding on to things too tightly a little bit, maybe. Before I go back to playing, also, interesting enough, this flute fits in the throat chakra, and it's really difficult to play if my throat isn't open and my neck isn't loose, so go figure. I believe we're at the color spectrum of reddish blue, just kind of like the sky right now. Perfectly like that, and with that I'm going to shut up again and go back to the music. Chakwachi. So the next chakra is the brow chakra. One thing that I learned today, I find interesting enough, you know the term highbrow. So if you're very judgmental and you're holding on to things once again, but if you're finding yourself judging all the time and evaluating and measuring and counting and you know all those things, your brow and your forehead get all uptight. You can even see it in people sometimes. And so I've found the perfect flute for that, because if you're uptight and you're judgmental, then you're gonna hate what I'm gonna do next. And if you can meditate through what comes next, then you definitely have a very solid practice and probably don't need me, but it would still be great if you check in with me every once in a while, because I'm losing my thought. Okay, so brow chakra, overtone flute from Colombia again. If you ever did an ayahuasca ceremony with shamans from Colombia, you might have heard this before. Brace yourself. Nanda, are you on your way? Okay. This is gonna be the last chakra. And I wanna thank you all for bearing with me for this whole thing. Especially Marta, since you just jumped in and you weren't planning for it. Hope you enjoyed it. The crown chakra. So, if you feel like getting up and dancing or something, you know, somebody wants to play the drums, we're now opening up the crown. And I forgot most of my script, but I also noticed how in the beginning when I was taking a long break to talk between music, I felt like you were kind of saying, don't talk so much.
Sort of.
No, but I appreciate it. That's,
I wasn't saying
that. No, but I was... Oh, louder, okay. So, but I was feeling that maybe I'm talking, the point is meditation and not me explaining how much I've learned about the chakras and how smart I am, you know? So I appreciate that as in moving along, you know? That's the way I try to interpret it. So like I did a little less talking than I was planning to, because I felt like it was kind of taking away from the experience a little bit. You know, I can maybe supply that in a sheet or like, you know, put it up on the website or something, you know, and like talking about it before was probably enough. You know? Okay, so I got one more for you guys if you want. And that would be in the key of G, and I'm just gonna kind of like do a little blowing. Ouch, my legs hurt.
Do you want me to join on the...
Yeah, you want to play the drums?
I like oh, wait. The last one actually. And I would yeah. add more animation to the meditation.
But then if you play the drum, you gotta get on camera with me.
Really?
Yeah, come on. Even though we're social distancing. Damn, this light is so good. I'm loving it. Let me see if it's... let me actually tune the drum. What time is it? Oh, I have it right here. Oh,
8:51.
50 minutes. 'm not on. Can we bring her on? Oh, it's not working. For some reason, it's not working. Here we go. Okay. Thank you. Thank you guys for watching. Next time when we have hundreds of followers watching, we'll do a question and answer. But I think today we're kind of limited on supplies here. So Nanda, we're waiting here for you, so I can do one last one for you. But I think I'm gonna shut off the broadcast right now. And thank you all for watching. I can't really see who else is on there except Nanda. And see you probably Sunday morning. I think I'll do another one from the park. Talk to you then, bye.